Good morning everyone. My name is Ismira Babu. I am working as a school student in biology science in Gorelapadutanna UPS Khammam district. In the last class we have discussed about few things about the marine ecosystem. Marine ecosystem is the ecosystem which is present in the seas and oceans. See, just like with the ecosystems present on the land, the animals present in the marine ecosystem also made adaptations in order to live in that environment, in the marine ecosystem. Adaptations means they have developed few techniques or they have changed their body features to live in that particular environment. They should procure food, they should carry reproduction, and they should also communicate with the other animals or other organisms, so that they have made various adaptations, which means various changes in their body to live in that environment. Today we will discuss about the zones present in the marine system based on the availability of the light. Based on the availability of the light in the depths of the seawater or ocean water, the seawater or ocean water is divided into three main zones. What are they? Three main zones. They are the photic zone or sunlight zone. Second one is the bathyal zone or dim light or twilight zone. Abyssal zone, which is also known as dark zone. So the based on the availability of the light, based on the availability of the light, the sea water or ocean water is divided into three different zones. First zone is euphotic zone or sunlight zone. The name itself indicates that sunlight zone means enough or adequate sunlight is present in this zone. The temperature would be from 1 degree centigrade to 30 degree centigrade. Up to 30 degree centigrade temperature will be there in this zone, and this the depth of this zone is from the surface of the sea water or ocean water up to the depth of 200 meters. Means from surface to the 200 meters depth, this zone is present. With what zone is it? Euphotic zone. Euphotic zone means enough sunlight is available in this zone. So as we all know that sunlight is the main source for the photosynthesis, isn't it? Yes, sunlight should be needed for the photosynthesis. The animals, the organisms which require sunlight lives in this zone, because sunlight is present in this zone only. So what are the organisms that take part in photosynthesis? The organisms which use sunlight and carbon dioxide, they prepare their food material, isn't it? That is called as photosynthesis. So the photosynthesis mostly takes place in this zone from the surface to the 200 meters depth, and which means the animals, the organisms which can use the sunlight lives in this zone only. Means, for example, the algae and the phytoplanktons, the algae and phytoplanktons and the diatoms, these are all the organisms which have chlorophyll in their body, and they can carry photosynthesis, so that these animals lives in this zone only. Like, see, the animals mostly present in this zone are either they are floaters or they are swimmers, and their body reflects the light. Either their body reflects the light, or their body becomes transparent, and they can swim freely in the surface water. Enough light is available in this zone, and enough temperature is also available in this zone, and there is less pressure, very less pressure in this zone. Less pressure is present in this zone. The animals like phytoplanktons, physeae, dolphins, flying fishes, green turtles, and sea animals, these are the main animals, and herring trouts are present in this zone. So So the animals, mostly 80% of the marine animals, marine organisms are seen only in this euphotic zone. The zone present beneath the euphotic zone is bathyal zone. It is dim light zone, very less light is available in this zone, and the temperature would be 4 degrees centigrade only. And from the depth of this zone is 200 meters to 2000 meters. Less temperature, less photosynthesis will take place in this zone, relatively euphotic zone. And these have flattened body, and there are the animals like whales, lanternfish, red brown crabs, and sea cucumbers, squids, and octopus, sponges, and corals. These are the various animals or organisms present or seen in this zone. See, comparatively, this zone we have less light than the euphotic zone, and temperature is also less than this euphotic zone. The depth, this zone is present just beneath the euphotic zone. And the third zone is abyssal zone, which is also known as dark zone. The name itself indicates dark means very few light, very less light. The light cannot penetrate into this zone, so that this zone would be dark throughout the year. It is dark throughout the year, and the temperature is also very less, 2 to 3 degrees centigrade. And where does this abyssal zone present? Just beneath the bathyal zone. See, from 2000 meters to 6000 meters, which means from surface to 200 meters, it is euphotic zone. From 200 to 2000 meters, it is bathyal zone. And from 2000 to 600 meters, it is abyssal zone or dark zone. Here is enough light, less light. Enough light is present in euphotic zone, less light is present in dim, bathyal zone, and the zone becomes dark throughout the year in abyssal zone or dark zone. See, the temperature is also here 30 degrees centigrade, and here 4 degrees centigrade, here 2 to 3 degrees centigrade only. The animals present in this zone carry mostly photosynthetic organisms, mostly seen in this zone only. And the animals which depends on the photosynthetic organisms also present in this zone, because the conditions are favorable for these animals. They see enough light is there, enough temperature is there, and less pressure is there, so that the animals can live freely without any adaptations in this zone. They need not make adaptations in their body. Mostly 80% of the flora and fauna is seen only in this euphotic zone. The zone present beneath the euphotic zone is bathyal zone, and the final zone is abyssal zone. It is dark here, temperature will be very less, and the animals like little star, anglerfish, and trifid fish, these are the animals seen in this zone. See, the animals which are present in this zone will have light producing organs. So these are the three zones present in the sea or oceans based on the availability of the light: euphotic zone, bathyal zone, and abyssal zone. Euphotic zone is up to, from the surface up to the 200 meter depth, and this zone is from 200 meters to 2000 meters, and this zone is from 6000 meters depth, and photosynthesis takes place maximum rate in euphotic zone. No photosynthesis takes place in this zone, and very less photosynthesis takes place in this zone. The flora and fauna, mostly 80% of the flora and fauna is seen in euphotic zone. The animals which lives in these two zones will have flattened body in order to adapt themselves by the pressure exerted by the water. And to adapt to the pressure present in these two zones, they have flattened body, and the animals which lives in this abyssal zone will be they don't have eyes, and sometimes they have light producing organs, and they have large mouth, and the animals will have flattened body. These are the three zones based on the availability of the salinity. And one more thing you have to remember, one interesting fact about the electric eel. It looks like snake, but it is not snake. If at all any predator comes near to this electric eel, it can generate 600 volts electricity, so that it can scare the predator. So that is why it can protect itself from the predators. So it is a fish-like organism. It is not a snake. It looks like snake, but it is not snake. These are the various zones present to in the marine ecosystem based on the light. One is euphotic zone. Second one is bathyal zone, abyssal zone, or dark zone. High amount of sunlight, enough sunlight is present, photosynthesis takes place at maximum rate, the animals will reflect the light, or they are transparent. Enough light is present, 90% 80% of the flora and fauna is seen in this zone. The second zone is bathyal zone, very less light color comparatively this euphotic zone. The animals which lives in abyssal zone or dark zone, they have a large mouth and a pointed teeth to leave the prey. They have a large mouth. So the animals will have flattened body. They have large mouth. How does this large mouth will help these organisms? They can catch their prey easily. They can catch their prey easily, and they have light producing organs around the mouth and on either side of the body and beneath their abdomen. To see, when we go deep into the layers, the pressure will increase, so that to maintain equilibrium pressure, these will have the organism which lives in this zone makes adaptations. They have flattened body to hold that pressure. They have flattened body, and these are mostly either these are carnivores or these are scavengers, or either these are carnivores or scavengers. So the animals which die in these two zones will finally reach this zone, so that the animals which are seen in this abyssal zone will feed on their dead bodies, and they have a large mouth, and they have light producing organs also. They have light producing organs also. Brittle stars, angler fish, and trifid fishes, these are the main animals seen in this zone. So these are the three zones based on the availability of the light. So from first zone is euphotic zone, and second zone is bathyal zone, and third zone is abyssal zone. In